Hi there, welcome back to Sisters Cast, where you are learning about material design with Material Design Light Framework. Well, in the last movie, you have learned that how you can work with material design grid in desktop. So this is the preview page we have worked in the last movie. Now in this movie, I'm going to show you that how you can actually work in tablet devices. And I'm going to pick up right from where we actually left off. So we will actually see it responsive. So now let's go ahead and let's learn about tablet grids here in this movie. So let me get back to here, and you can see this is the same file we have worked in the last movie. So you see, actually I have this one row which is actually empty grid, and I have this four cell, see here, four cell, and each cell have three columns, so it's going to fit right here. See, 12, cool. Now next we have this three cell which actually have a four column in each, so it's again 12, so you see it's fitting here. Great. Now we next have two cell, and this is the last one, and each cell have a six column, so you can see now 6 6 12, so now you can see it's fitting right here, which is really nice. And now you know that in desktop there's actually 12 column, but in tablet devices there's actually only 8 column to work with. So if you're using 8 column, then you are actually working with entire tablet viewport. Yeah, 8 column, remember this one, this is really important. Tablet 8, desktop 12. Great. So very first of all, let me just make sure that we are in tablet device. For that, it's really easy to understand. How? Because MDL framework is already providing you some classes where you can actually just make it visible once we actually switch to tablet from desktop. So let me get back to here, and let me go up here, right? And I can just go ahead and simply hit Ctrl D to just duplicate it. And here I'm going to give it a class of this MDL cell. And here I'm going to show, okay, fine, just go ahead and hide in where tablet devices, because this is desktop, right? So this is desktop, so it's going to hide on tablet devices. So now I can simply just go ahead, copy this one, and here I'm gonna say, okay, just go ahead and hide on where desktop. So now it's actually going to hide on desktop, so this tablet, right? Sorry, I forgot to, like, you know, write here. So now this tablet is going to hide on desktop, and this desktop is going to hide on tablet. So if we get back to here, if I reload it, you can see desktop is still appearing here. If I just go ahead and try to resize it, see, if that appearing or if that visible, that simply means we are in desktop. But as soon it's actually turned into tablet, I mean, it's actually going to replace this one in tablet. See, if I just go ahead and once again resize, see, now this is to tablet here. See, now this is actually tablet device, this is desktop device, tablet, desktop, cool. And in tablet, you can see it's not look really nice here. Yeah, it's not look nice. So I'm going to just keep this same markup, but I'm going to make it really look nice. Okay, fine. So now you know that in tablet we have 8 column to work, but in desktop 12 column. Again, it's really important to understand 8 column in tablet. Now I can simply get back to here, and now you can see here that here by default I'm using this very default stuff here, MDL dash shell underscore underscore 3 column, but there's actually more classes you can apply. You have the classes that you can explicitly define for desktop, tablet and phones, and I will talk about it in just a minute. But here you can see by default there's actually 3 and 3 is 6. Now tablet have 8 columns, so it's 6, but this is going to be 9, so this is not going to fit there. So that's why it's using this 3 and 3 column, but we are wasting this 2 column here. Yeah, 2 column again. Let me show you. If I just go ahead and make this 2 here, now this is gonna be 3, 3, 6, and now this is 2, it's gonna be 8. And now if I get back to here, you see, it's fitting right here. See, I didn't lie about it, right? Okay, great. So you can see it's fitting here, which is really nice. And you can see there's actually a lot of margin here, and that's because of here. See? That's because of this one, right? So let me actually now just keep this 5M from top and bottom, but from the left right, let's say here 2M. And if I get back to here, reload it, you can see it's now got a little bit less margin. If you want to even make it even or more less, you can simply say 1 here. And if I go to here, you can see now it's perfect, right? Cool. So now you know that in tablet we have 8 column to work with. So if I get back to here, I can simply just go to here. And now how do you reorganize this stuff here? Well, it's really easy. Let me first go ahead and make it this 3 here. So it's gonna be in desktop, it's gonna be 3. But now we are explicitly going to say that if you switch to tablet, just make this, you know, based on your customization. So let me show you. You can see here MDL sell, and then you can see here double dash, and you can see how much. Well, let's say here, I have 8 column to work with, so let's say here 4 column, right? So say here 4 col, and here you need to explicitly say that, okay, fine, I want in tablet here. It's really important. Now you can simply just go ahead and copy this part here, because in tablet you need 4 column this cell. This cell also you need 4 column. This one, let's say here 4 column, and later we'll modify it. This one I also want in 4 column. This one I also want in 4 column. This one also, and this one also, and we have, I think, 2 more. There we go. So now I have just set it here that, okay, fine, my each cell have 4 column in tablet devices. If I get back to it, you can see now if I just go ahead reload it, now you can see everyone is going to look really nice. See? Yes. And you can't see that another one here is that only because of, let me just get back to here, and you can see here that now we have this one, two. So this is gonna be one row, this is gonna be 1, 2, so this is gonna be another row, this is gonna be 1, 2, this is gonna be another row, and this is actually 1 and 2, this is another row, and this is 1. So it's going to be like only single in the row, you can see here, right? So this is really cool. And now let me show you that if you want to make it like, you know, 4 cell in this one row, you can do that. You know how to do that, right? You can simply go up here, and now you have 8 column to work with. You can simply say here that in tablet devices I need this one to be 2 and this one to be 2, right? And now you can simply say this one is also I need 2 here, and this one, okay, I need make it 2 here. There we go. If I get back to here, now I have this 4 column, 1, 2, 3, and 4 cells, okay? And now each cell have a 2 column. I mean, 2 into 4 is 8, so it's going to fit in one row. See, it's fitting up here, which is really nice. See, cool. So now if you want to, like, you know, let me just get back to here, and because here, let me show you, here we actually have this 3 column. See, 3, 1, so you can see here that, okay, fine, I want it, let's say, 2, but I want this part to be 4, but this one I need to be 2. So now this 3 is going to fit in one row here. Let me show you. If you get back to here, see, this is a 2 column of cell, this is a 4 column, and this is 2 column. It's fitting here. And now at the very last, we have this 4 and 4, which is going to be 8, and you can say 4 and 4, 8. So this is how we can actually work in this tablet devices. So now it's responsive. Yeah, let me show you. If I switch to here, you can see, oh, it's really look nice in desktop devices, but as soon as I hit tablet device, see, it still look nice in tablet devices, isn't it? Now let's go ahead and talk about this mobile devices. See, it's not look nice in mobile devices. So you can see MDL desktop, MDL tablet, because now there's no desktop, there's no tablet, it's actually a phone version. So now let's go ahead and let's work on phone in the next movie. Great.